Having discussed both vertical and horizontal scaling solutions, let's take a look at their combination, diagonal scaling. Plasma extends on the idea of sidechains, which we explained in the previous section. Plasma is a child chain attached to the Ethereum main chain, also known as the root chain. In Plasma, security of off-chain transactions is derived from the root chain. The root chain is the main source of truth within the system, and acts as an arbiter in the case of dispute. A user's interaction with Plasma might be as follows. The user would first deposit some ETH into a root chain smart contract, living on the main Ethereum network. The initial deposit would show up as an unspent transaction output on the sidechain. This will allow the user to then send transactions around within the Plasma or child chain. At any point in time, the user could attempt to exit a UTXO on the Plasma child chain back to the root chain. An issue here is that we have to verify the validity of the exit. For example, maybe the user is trying to exit a UTXO that has already been spent. So to disincentivize malicious exiting, we require exiting users to post bond and also implement an exit challenging mechanism. If we detect malicious exiting, the user's posted bond will be slashed. If nothing is wrong, then the exit is finalized. In either case, the result is posted on the root chain, which serves as the source of truth. Plasma is being developed by Blockchain Berkeley's Fourth State Labs. You can find a link to them on the slide and also at github.com/fourthstate. Plasma's been getting a lot of attention recently, and for good reason. Vitalik Buterin himself had stated that Plasma, in conjunction with sharding, complementary layer 2 and layer 1 scaling solutions, could potentially scale Ethereum transaction speed up by 10,000 times. And speaking of layer scalability, the Plasma specification says nothing about where and how to host a child chain, so it's up to implementation. The Fourth State team had a clear vision of interoperability in their Plasma implementation, and chose to build their child chain implementation on Cosmos. Here's a picture of our team getting a well-deserved shout-out at the 4th Global Blockchain Summit 2018. We consider Plasma a diagonal scaling solution because it scales up the number of Ethereum transactions that the network can handle by bringing the transactions off the main chain onto child chains, which could be used to extend Ethereum's functionality. And this is especially the case if you view Plasma with a particular sense of modularity. Plasma is one component of the larger scalability ecosystem. We saw this back with Vitalik's hopes of Plasma plus sharding. And with the Fourth State team's implementation of Plasma on Cosmos, it especially opens up the door for interoperability. So before introducing Cosmos from the scalability perspective, it's nice to take a step back and understand the primitives upon which it functions. Traditionally, you can view blockchains with three main abstraction layers. There's the application layer at the very top that processes transactions and updates the state of the system, and defines the distributed application that you're building. This could be peer-to-peer electronic cash, or general smart contract computation, or any other use case. Below that, there's a need for a consensus layer to make sure that the entire network agrees on transactions and updates made to the underlying distributed database. And below that, there's the network itself, tasked with propagating transactions through the network, making sure all nodes are getting updates within reasonable time. In the early days, developers directly forked the Bitcoin codebase for the lower levels of consensus and networking. This worked for a bit, but was inflexible, especially for applications that required increasingly specialized architectures, distinguishing themselves from Bitcoin standard UTXOs, proof of work, scripting language, etc. Then, with the advent of Ethereum, writing blockchain applications became simpler than ever, since you can now just write your smart contract very succinctly in a high-level language, running on the Ethereum network and consensus layers. Again, though, this still tied the fate of smart contracts to the state of the Ethereum system. And since scalability hasn't been solved as of yet, this is currently still an issue. Then, the goal of the Tendermint project was to create a fully modular blockchain middleware that provides networking and consensus layers. This allows arbitrary applications to be built on top of Tendermint with the ABCI, or Application Blockchain Interface. An advantage of this modular design is that of flexibility, which lends itself quite naturally to the idea of the Cosmos network. An advantage of this modular design is that of flexibility. Which lends itself quite naturally to the idea of the Cosmos network, an idea to connect blockchains together to become an internet of blockchains. Blockchains in the Cosmos network would be diagonally scaled. We can achieve vertical scaling by the speed of Tendermint BFT consensus and horizontal scaling by the interoperability of the Cosmos network itself. We won't dive too in depth here, but the general topology of the Cosmos network consists of hubs and zones, each either running Tendermint or having a data transform layer. Hubs connect multiple zones together, and hubs and zones are all blockchains supporting their own applications, whether they be simple payment blockchains or a full-fledged port of Ethereum onto Tendermint.